Hello everyone. Today let us solve a particular problem based on kinematics of linear motion. So here we can see the question. The question is, a particle is dropped from the top of a tower which is 100 meter high, and another particle at the same time is projected in the upward at the same time from the bottom of the tower, that is foot of the tower, and meets the first particle at a height of 30 meter. Now you have to find out the velocity with which the second particle is projected in upward direction, and you have to take acceleration due to gravity, that g is 9.8 meter per second square. So based on the question, let us draw the diagram. Imagine that this is a tower. And the height of the tower is 100 meters. Now from the top of the tower, the particle is dropped. Now here the initial velocity is zero. Now at the same time, another particle, this is the second particle, is projected in the upward direction, and both the particles, they are meeting somewhere here, and that height is given to you, that is as 30 meters. So you have to find out what velocity the second particle is thrown in the upward direction. So let us see here the given data. Let us write down. So the initial, the given data is the height of the tower. The height of the height of the tower is given as 100 meter. Now here you can see, this is the first particle which you are dropping from the height. So the initial velocity of the first particle, as it is dropped from the top of the tower, the initial velocity, of the first particle. So here the first particle is a particle which you are dropping from a height of 100 meters. The initial velocity of the first particle is zero, which we will take it as u1. Now the height where the both the particles meet, the height where the both the particles meet. So that is also given in the question. The height at which the both the particles are meeting is 30 meters. Yeah. So from this, we can say that the distance traveled by the second particle, that is, which is thrown in upward direction at the same time, distance traveled by the second particle, let us take it as h2. h2 is how much? The distance traveled is 30 meters, which is also given by the question. So, as the height of the tower is 100 meters, distance traveled by the second particle is 30 meters. So, easily from this, you can write down what is the distance traveled by the first particle. So, the distance traveled by the first particle will be how much? The total height of the tower minus distance traveled by the second particle. Clear? So, the distance traveled by the first particle, this is, it's coming around, is 100 minus 30, so it is 70 meters. Okay, so this 70 meters is your S1. So S2 is the distance traveled by the second particle, and S1 is the distance traveled by the first particle. Now, let us take assume let us assume t so let us assume t as t as the time when the two particles meet. That is the time when the two particles meet. And u2 is the initial velocity of the second particle, which you have to find it out. So u2 is the initial velocity of the second particle, which is thrown in the vertically upward direction. So here there are two cases. So the case one is when the particle is dropped from the top of the tower. What is the case one? When the particle is dropped from the top of the tower. So this, in this case, we'll use the equation, that is kinematics of linear equation, kinematics of linear motion equation, that is S is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay. So as when the particle is dropped from the top of the tower, which particle are we talking about? That is the first particle. Clear? So In the as is it is the first particle, so we'll take s1 is equal to the initial velocity. As we have seen, the initial velocity of this particular particle, in this we have already seen that in this diagram the initial velocity is zero, okay, of the first particle. Clear? So here s, in what is the initial velocity? Initial velocity is 0 into t plus half at square. So as the particle is dropping, so this is nothing but acceleration due to gravity and half at square. So the distance traveled by the first particle we have taken as 70. And 70 is equal to half multiplied by e is 9.8 t squared. Clear? So the equation is 70 is equal to, so 9.8 by 2 is 4.9 t squared. So you calculate in the calculator, so t is equal to root r of 70 by 4.9. Yeah. So it is 70 divided by 4.9 with root of, it's coming how much? 3.779. So we'll round it up. That is 3.78 seconds. So this is the time taken by the first particle to meet the second particle. Okay. So the time we got it as 3.78 seconds. Now let us take the second case. So what is the second case? Case 2. So what is case 2? That is, we are talking about the second particle. Now the second part, in case 2, the second particle, is projected or thrown, in vertically upward, So here also we do use the same equation of linear motion, that is s is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay, so already we know, so this becomes as h2 is equal to u2t. Why u2? Because we are finding out this velocity of the second particle. With what velocity? This actually we are going to find out. U2 plus half gt square. So in the previous thing, we have already got t as 3.78 seconds. So you know already s2 is how much? S2 is 30 meters. Okay. So s2 is 30 meters. U2 into the t, how much you got it? 3.78. Clear? You can see here we got it in the previous. T is how much you got it? In this you got t is equal to 3.78. So this particular value of t we are going to use here in this particular equation. So u2 is how much? U2 into 3.78 seconds plus half g as is given in the question, you have to take 9.8 meter per second square, and t square, again t is how much? 3.78 whole square. So here you have only one unknown, that is u2. From here you have to find it out. So let us solve here. So 30 is equal to 3.78 u2. Let us calculate this in calculator. So 9.8 into 3.78 into 3.78 divided by 2. We got 70.01. So how much you got? 70.01. Okay. So here you can see this portion here, this. So what we have done, as this is thrown in which direction? This is thrown in your vertically upward direction. When it is thrown in vertically upward direction, clear? So this question, this particular thing, equation becomes what? As you all know, when it is, when the particle is coming in downward direction, it is minus, and when it is projected vertically upward, this becomes minus actually. Okay, ut minus half gt square. You know that when the particle is coming down, A is equal to plus g, and when the particle is thrown against the gravity in upward direction, you know A is equal to minus g. Okay, so here while solving, what you'll get, u2 is equal to 30 plus 70.01 divided by 3.78. So this is u2. So 30 plus 70 let us calculate 30 plus 70.01 divided by 3.78. how much you got? 26.45. Yeah, so 26.45 meter per second. So this is what is the answer, with what velocity actually at the same time the second particle is thrown in the upward direction. So you got the answer as 26.45 meter per second. I hope you have understood. Okay, thank you.